Warning, viewing of this program has been shown to cause permanent brain damage in laboratory animals. You should consult your physician before attempting to view any of the program material. Deep beneath the surface of the Metroplex, there exists the Texas 27 Film Vault, a massive complex filled to capacity with an endless array of cinema classics. Join our Film Vault technicians, Randy, Richard, and Laurie, as they venture into the vast library of motion pictures to bring you the finest in cinematic excitement, the Texas 27 Film Vault. Elvira. Who is she? What is she? And why is she on Channel Roller Rock? Tonight, the shocking truth is uncovered as Randy and Richard present Exposé Elvira. Is she or isn't he?
Lips like cherry wine. That girl can sure enough make my dream.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to yet another exciting adventure in cinema at the Texas 27 Film Vault. I'm Randy.
And I'm Richard. Tonight's movie, Vault of Horror, starring Kurt Jurgens and Roy Baker, is truly a classic horror film at its finest. It's five horror tales dealing with murder, torture, vampires, and of course, voodoo. But tonight, while enjoying this fine horror film, you will witness a startling revelation made exclusive to KDFI Texas 27 by anonymous individuals. Randy?
Thank you, Richard. For several weeks now, we've been urging the viewers to make the switch from Elvira on channel blah, 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 to the Film Vault. Why? Well, several weeks ago, Richard was contacted by a mysterious woman who claims to be the sister of Elvira. After much skepticism on my part, Richard finally persuaded me to meet with this woman. And what I found out astounded me.
What do you mean, are they real? Of course they're real. Besides, I thought we were talking about my sister Elvira.
Yes, yes, of course. Go on.
Well, anyway, as I was telling you before, I have just about had it up to here with this Elvira business. She's sitting there in California, raking in all that fame and fortune, not to mention the money she's making. And you think that once, just once in that whole 5 years, she even picked up the phone to call her sister? Certainly not. And I have had enough of this charade.
Charade? Could you elaborate, Indira?
I beg your pardon?
Could you explain what you mean by charade?
Oh, sure. Well, it seems that my sister Elvira, well, Elvira, she's...
Different?
Yeah, you could use that word, different, uh-huh.
Well, go on.
Yes, go on.
Well, it seems that Elvira, my sister, well, she's not my sister at all. She's my brother.
Shocking, yes. But was she telling the truth?
What do you mean am I telling the truth? Of course I'm telling the truth. Besides, do I look like a girl that would lead you on?
Well, quite frankly,
Miss... Besides, I've got witnesses.
Witnesses?
Yes, witnesses. You know, friends of the family, relatives, old school chums. By the way, who are you two anyway?
I'm Randy.
And I'm Richard.
And when we return, we'll chat with a longtime friend and confidant of Elvira's, whose name we cannot reveal.
Why, if Bernie knew I was telling this, he'd break my neck.
And now, tonight's spooky spectacular, Vault of Horror.
Elvira.
What? Well, shoot, yeah? Why, Ernie, Elvira. Why, we go back a long way. Why, we was best friends before he got famous. Why, if Ernie knew I was telling this, he'd break my neck.
Break your neck. Could you elaborate, John?
Huh?
Could you explain it to us, please?
Oh, yeah, I see. Well, that boy or girl is 6'6", and weighs in it near 285 pounds. He's mean, too. Why, I remember many a time he'd break a man's jaw for getting the wrong idea, yes, sir.
Well, the wrong idea, John?
Well, you see, that boy, that girl, well, he had this thing for black low-cut dresses and wigs. I never could understand it. And makeup? Shoot! Why, nothing he liked better than a facial or two a day. But you understand, people who didn't know Ernie, they sort of got the weird idea that he was a little, you know...
Strange?
Or different.
And?
Well, someone shoot off his mouth and he'd just haul off and knock the hell out of him. Pow, boom, that boy be out cold. I always told him he ought to try out for one of them kung fu movies. I'd say, Ernie, you got a future in pictures, boy. You could be as big as Bruce Lee. But no, he wanted to go out in fancy gowns.
So, John, what you're basically telling us is that Elvira the woman is not a woman at all. Elvira is, in fact, your best friend, Ernie.
Yeah? And that's not all. He's a man, too.
Right, right. John, I have a picture here I'd like you to look at. Is this Ernie, John?
Yeah, that's old Ernie. Elvira. I don't remember him looking so good. Look at that. He got rid of that mustache, too. Makes a difference. Yes, sirree.
Are you absolutely sure that this is Ernie, John?
Oh, sure. Couldn't be nobody else. Why, that family trait sticks out like a sore thumb. Yes, indeedy. Oh, look at that. Kind of stares you in the face.
You mean his chest?
No. The chin. The chin.
Yeah, well, thank you very much, John. Thank you.
Sure, my pleasure. Now about that $200 you talked about.
Oh, of course. Let me just get this light and I'll write you a check.
What are you doing? Do that damn thing.
Conclusive evidence? Hardly. But we found out through further conversations with his college football team that Ernie, All-American linebacker of 1970, drafted fifth in the 1971 NFL draft, was indeed Kennel Brawl's Elvira, Mistress of the Dark.
Our first thought, why? Why give up such a promising career in professional football?
Our second thought, how in the world could a middle linebacker look so good in a low-cut dress?
When we return, we'll resolve this mystery once and for all.
Elvira.
Exposé Elvira.
Elvira.
Is she or isn't he? We'll continue. But first, back to our...
As you've witnessed throughout tonight's show, we're investigating what could possibly be the year's biggest headline. Elvira on channel blah, 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 is in reality Ernie, all-around good guy. This according to his sister, Indira.
But is Indira really Elvira's sister? I asked her.
I just love a man in a helmet.
That didn't work, so I asked her.
Well, if you just get that screen test that you promised me.
So we both asked her.
Brother, what a couple of nerds. How many times do I have to tell you boys I am Elvira's sister? He's my brother.
Yes, but can you prove that, Indira?
Prove it! Prove it! What more proof do I need?
I'm convinced. How about you?
I certainly am convinced.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But I wasn't convinced. We needed conclusive evidence. Hard facts. We needed something we could sink our teeth into.
If I only could put my finger on what it was.
You guys lay another finger on me, and I'm telling you something, I'm going to break your necks. Now, let me get this straight. You want me to go to L.A. With a film crew.
Yeah.
You want me to bust through Elvira's studio.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Catch her while she's filming.
Right,
and
right.
Prove with Jan, beyond
yes.
a shadow of a doubt, that Elvira is my brother or my sister. Oh, you know what I mean. That's what you want?
Yes, that's what we want.
Oh, come on, you guys, give me a break.
Well, how about a check instead?
Oh, well, yes, that sounds great. Shall I reserve the flight?
When we return, you'll witness the shocking conclusion of this report.
And what you see may terrify you, but in the interest of honest journalism, we feel it necessary to reveal the facts. Once and for all.
We interrupt this tape broadcast to bring you this special report. Here's Randy Clower.
I've traveled to Cow's Ear, Texas, for an exclusive interview with the father of Elvira, Elvis Bigaball. He's a garage mechanic in his own garage on Bubba Boulevard. Let's speak to him now. Mr. Bigaball.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Bigaball, could you come out and address our film vault cameras?
Sure thing. Sure. What do you want to talk about?
Well, we'd like to talk to you about your daughter, Elvira.
Oh, you mean Ernie?
Yeah, Ernie.
Well, sure. I don't mind. Let me get out of here.
Well, let me help you out.
Okay. Just a minute.
Okay, here we go. Let me help you stand up.
Thank you, Mitch.
Thank you so much for talking with us today.
Uh-huh.
Let me ask you something about your daughter, or son, Ernie. Weren't you a little concerned when he was growing up that he seemed to enjoy dressing up in women's clothing? Weren't you concerned about that?
Oh, no, I wasn't concerned about that at all. But I say I was a little bit bothered about his makeup. You know, because we Bingaballs, we always like to be a little bit natural, you know, the way God intended it. But looking back on it, I figured it must be his sister, His sister must have done that for him.
You mean Indira?
Hmm. Yep.
Could you elaborate on all of this, please?
Huh?
Could you explain to us?
Oh, well, yeah, you know, Indira, she was a little bit, well, jealous, you know, because Ernie, he was getting all the looks, you know, and just every Tom, Dick, and Harry just figured he was just beautiful. And, well, you know, just between you and me, he was. Best looking bingo ball in the whole family. But, you know, after all, he takes after his mother, Ira.
By the way, where is Mrs. Bigaball?
But she's in training right now.
Training?
Yeah, she's a professional wrestler. Has been for years. She got real good at it, too. But she had plenty of time to be a good mother and homemaker.
Well that's very interesting. How did Ernie acquire the name Elvira?
Oh, well, you know, as he got a little bit older, when he started to grow up and bloom, you know, like all the Bingo Boy boys him have a tendency to do, well, we just knew he was destined for something special, because everywhere that boy went, he would just turn heads. And being the proud parents that we was, we was the one that gave him nickname Elvira. You know, Elvis and Ira, you know, that's Elvira.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's fascinating, sir.
Yeah, that's what everybody said. Mm. You know, he was real famous before he even got on TV.
How so?
Well, he used to hang around with these boys up there at Memphis. They used to sing music all around town. They took a real good liking to that son of ours, and they wrote a song just special for him. You might even heard of it. It was called, it's a catchy little tune. It goes like,
okay. Elvira.
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 Exposé Elvira. Is she or isn't he? We'll return right now. And now, the conclusion of tonight's investigative report, Exposé Elvira. Is she or isn't he?
Elvira, queen of the macabre or king of delusion? Is she for real or is he a fake?
What we discovered in her L.A. studio was somewhat of a shock. But because we believe in honest journalism, because we believe that freedom of the press is a God-given right, because we believe in truth, justice, and the American way.
And most importantly, without high ratings, we may never work again.
We felt you, the viewer, would see what we saw in its unedited form. So please, prepare yourself. Could we roll that now, please?
Hi, this is Indira coming to you from L.A. I'm here in the studios, and I've managed to make it past security. Now we're going to go down, and we're going to see, is Ernie my brother really Elvira? You bet, honey. Let me tell you. Come on down here. Now, don't trip over those wires or anything. Come on. Come on. Come on now. What the? Come on now. Come on.
I think it's right down here. I think. Now, just a minute here. Oh, young man, do you know where, pardon me, do you know where Elvira is? Evidently, you rude thing. Oh, I beg your pardon. Oh, this is it. This is it. The gray. This is it. Gray stripe. Red stripe. I remember this. Hey, honey, honey, I'm here to see Ernie, my brother. Ernie, honey, I'm here to see Ernie.
No, you can't.
I beg your pardon. I certainly. Hey, get out of the way. Ernie, honey, I came to see you. Oh, honey, you look so good.
And there it is, the shocking conclusion to tonight's Elvira expose. Is she or isn't he? Made exclusive to the Film Vault crew here at the Texas 27 Film Vault.
Yes. Randy, I think it's time that we thanked all our friends and relatives and the crew for taking the time out of their lives to bring us this painstaking report. But there's one thing I'd like to know.
What is that, Ricardo?
How did they get Elvira or Ernie to look so good on the screen?
That's simple. They use lots of mirrors and electrolysis.
That, Randy, is incredible.
Haha, but speaking of incredible, next week here in the Texas 27 Film Vault, we will be showing Racket Busters with Humphrey Bogart.
Hello, boys.
Good
move. Hello, boys.
I don't. It's Indira.
Ladies and gentlemen, the sister of.
I
don't understand.
It's Indira, and she's back, and I'm kind of surprised. I wasn't expecting to see you.
Well, I bet you boys are surprised, you know. Nothing's wrong, honey. Nothing's wrong at all.
I was about to say, did you have a problem finding your way out of here?
No problems. Nothing's wrong, honey. Everything's just fine.
Well, what's wrong?
Fine.
Well, what is it then?
Well,
what's
the deal here?
You know, boys, it's not every day a girl gets to work with two fine talents like yourself.
Well, thank you
very much.
Well,
that's very nice.
Okay, let me tell you something. Just because you've been so sweet, I want to repay your generosity.
Oh, well, that's really not necessary.
Boy. No, that's not necessary.
I insist, honey.
Well, okay, what do you got in mind?
Well, yeah.
Well, something very special.
Well, like what?
What is this thing? What is this thing?
Wait, yeah.
It's a surprise.
A surprise? I love surprises.
Oh, this is great. Surprises. I
love
it.
Oh, great. But, boys, first, you're going to have to play by my rules.
Okay.
First, close your eyes.
Okay, I can do that.
Okay, very good. Now, say the magic word.
Oh, magic word.
Magic word.
Please. Give it to me. There you go, honey. That's for the magic. And that's for making a fool out of me. You guys are a bunch of fakes. Phonies, that's right. Let me tell you something. I have had it up to here. These boys said they'd make me a big star. Well, so far all I see is a check that's bounced. And it's not even worth the paper it's written on. That's right. I've had it to here, and I'm leaving. But when I come back, I'm bringing my lawyer. And guess what? When he gets through with you two, you won't even have so much as a can to sit on.
But,
goodbye, big creep.
Ignore that. Just ignore that. She gets a little testy at times.
Next week.
Until next week, I'm Randy.
And I'm Richard.
Good night.
Good night, everybody. You and your big ideas. I thought we could
have worked. Fault.
No, it wasn't my fault. Wait a minute.
She's such a kidder.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it.
Elvira. My heart's on fire for Elvira. Eyes that look like heaven, lips like cherry wine. That girl can smell a wing, just for you, I'm in this way.
wings.